My dear students, in my previous video, we discussed about the condition for the two lines to be perpendicular and parallel. If the two lines are parallel, we derive the condition first. That is, these are the two lines A1x plus B1y plus C1 equal to 0 is one line. Another line is A2x plus B2y plus C2 equal to 0. If these two lines are parallel, if these two lines are parallel, then the condition is, if these two lines are parallel, the condition is A1 by B1 equal to A2 by B2. We derived this condition in our previous video. If these two lines are parallel, the condition is A1 by B1 equal to A2 by B2. That means the coefficients are proportional. Coefficients of X and Y are proportional. Or I can say the coefficients are equal. They are differ only by constant. The equation of two parallel lines differ only by constant. Ax plus by plus c1 equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c2 equal to 0. This is one particular case. Another case is the coefficients should be proportional. And those two ideas I gave in our previous video. I explained in the previous video. That is, 2x plus 3y plus 4 equal to 0, 6x plus 9y proportional, 2 3s are 6, 3 3s are 9, minus 7 equal to, these are the two lines. These two lines are parallel because the coefficients are proportional. And also the slopes are equal, 2 by 3, 2 by 3. 6 by 9 is, 6 by 9 is also 2 by 3. Similarly, another case, 2x plus 3y plus 4 equal to 0, 2x plus 3y minus 10 is also equal to 0. See, these two lines are also parallel because coefficients are exactly same, they are differ by constant only. Like that, these are the two cases we have seen in our previous video. If the two lines are parallel, the condition is A1 by B1 equal to A2 by B2. This is the condition. And the coefficients are proportional or the coefficients are exactly equal. Now, distance between these two parallel lines, A1x plus B1y plus C1 equal to C2 equal to 0. This is our present idea in this video. AX plus BY plus C1 equal to 0 and AX plus BY plus C2 equal to 0. These two lines are parallel because coefficients are exactly same. They differ only by constant. So, distance between these two parallel lines, distance between these two, distance between these two parallel lines is D equal to mod of C1 minus C2, modulus of C1 minus C2 by root of coefficients of X square plus coefficient of Y square, A square plus. This is the condition for the two lines are parallel. Yeah, sorry, distance between two lines are parallel. Distance between these two lines are mod of C1, modulus of C1 minus C2, magnitude of C1 minus C2 by root of coefficient of S and coefficient of Y. Yes, we have to be. Using this idea, I am going to solve one problem. So these are the things you have seen already in our previous video. Consider the two lines and find the distance between these two lines. There are two lines given and they ask you to find out the distance between the two parallel lines. Consider the lines 15x plus 8y minus 34 equal to 0. This is one line. Another line is again 15x plus 8y plus 31 equal to 0. These two lines are parallel because coefficients of x and y are exactly same. They differ, the two equations differ only by constant. Therefore, by using this idea, distance between these two lines distance between these two parallel lines is d equal to modulus of c1. C1 is minus 34, c2 minus 31, modulus of c1 minus c2, c1 minus 34, c2 plus 31, therefore minus c2, c1 minus c2 by root of a square is 15 square plus b square is 8 square. That is equal to modulus of 34 minus 31 minus of 65. Taking modulus, we will get 65 only. Minus 65, magnitude is 65. Modulus only you have to take. This is equal to mod of minus 65 by root of 15 square is 225, 8 square is 64. Modulus of magnitude of negative 65 is positive 65 by root of 225 plus 64 is 289. Root of 289 is 17. 65 by 17. This is the distance between these two parallel lines is 65 by 17 square units. So that's all about the problem. Finding the distance between the two parallel lines is this. I give one example also. 289. That is 65 by 17 is the distance between two parallel lines. Next, I am going to give the condition for the two lines are perpendicular and how the equations occur in the case of two perpendicular lines. The condition is we have derived already. It is in our previous video, we have derived the condition for two parallel lines and perpendicular lines also. If the two lines a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, if these two lines, if a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, if these two lines are perpendicular, we know the condition. We derived the condition already in our previous video. If these two lines are perpendicular, the condition is a1, a2 plus b1, b2 equal to 0. We derived this condition already by slope of line 1 and the slope of line 2, m1 and m2, and product of their slopes is minus 1. If the two lines are perpendicular, product of their slope is m1 and m2 is minus 1. Using this idea, we derived that a1, a2 plus b1, b2 equal to 0. From this I can write a1, a2 equal to minus b1, b2, and what is that? A2 by B1. I rewrite this as A2 by B1 equal to minus B2 by A1. From this expression, I got this, I bring that B1, B2, I take that B1, B2 to the right hand side, I get minus B1, B2. From this expression, I get A2 by B1 equal to minus B2 by A1. Since these are proportional, we equate it to the constant lambda. A2 by B1 equal to minus B2 by A1, and both these two ratios are equal to some constant lambda. From this, I get A2 equal to lambda B1 and B2 equal to minus A, therefore minus lambda A1. A2 equal to lambda B1. A1 equal to minus B2. What is that? B2 equal to minus A1 lambda. You replace A2 and B2 in the equation 2. You have, from the equation 2, from the equation A2x plus B2y plus C2 equal to 0, in this equation you replace A2 by lambda B1x. A2 is replaced by lambda B1, therefore lambda B1x. B2 is replaced by minus lambda A1y plus C2 equal to 0. A2 is replaced by lambda B1x. B2 is replaced by minus lambda A1y plus C2 equal to 0. Divide the entire equation throughout by lambda B1x. Divide by lambda B1x minus A1y. Divided by lambda B1x minus lambda by lambda is A1y plus C2 by lambda equal to 0. Since again this C2 and lambda are constant, therefore I can write it as B1x minus A1y plus some k equal to 0. I replace C2 by lambda as another constant k. Consider the first equation. Consider in the equation of line 1. Consider the equation 1. What is that? A1x plus B1y plus C1 equal to 0. Second equation is A2x, instead of that I get B1x minus A1y plus k equal to 0. See, from this I get, if the two lines are perpendicular, first equation you write as it is, second equation coefficient of y becomes the coefficient of x, and the coefficient of x is becomes the coefficient of y with negative sign. The coefficients of x and y are interchanged, and with a sign also, change of sign, negatively. Coefficient of x becomes coefficient of y with negative sign. Coefficient of y becomes coefficient of x. Here, first equation b1, y coefficient, in the second equation it becomes coefficient of x. In the first equation, coefficient of x a1 becomes the coefficient of y of the second equation with negative sign. Example, 3x plus 4y minus 7 equal to 0. Line perpendicular to this line is, a line perpendicular to this line is 4x minus 3y. Coefficient of x becomes coefficient of y, coefficient of y becomes coefficient of x. Plus some constant of k equal to 0, whatever it may be. Coefficient of x and y are interchanged with the sign. So, this is if the line, the given line, the perpendicular to the given line is coefficient of x and y are interchanged, and either one of the sign would be negative. One more example, so say for example 2x minus 3y plus 3 equal to 0. Perpendicular line is coefficient of x is 2, coefficient of y is 3, that is, what is it? Coefficient of x becomes coefficient of y. That is coefficient of 3y plus 2x plus k equal to 0. coefficient of x 2 becomes coefficient of y. Coefficient of x minus 3 becomes coefficient of x minus 3x. Coefficient of y 2, x here becomes minus 2y. X is minus 3. Coefficient of y is minus 3x. Coefficient of x is minus 2x. Sign should be changed. Plus some other constant k. Like that, these two equations are. Perpendicular. First line and the second line can be the coefficients of x and y are interchanged with the either one of x or y should be changed. Sign of the either one coefficient of x or y should be changed. Like that. Okay. This is the condition for two lines are perpendicular and the perpendicular equations exist like this one. Now, we'll solve one problem. Find the equation of the line. Perpendicular to a line. Using this idea, I am going to solve a problem. Find the equation of the line perpendicular to the line x minus 7y plus 5 equal to 0. X minus 7y plus 5 equal to 0 and having x intercept 3. That's all the problem. Find the equation of the line perpendicular to the line x minus 7y plus 5 equal to 0 having x intercept is 3. See, you have to find out the line perpendicular to the given line and it passes through the point making x intercept is 3. X-intercept 3 means the passing point is the line passing through 3, 0 because x-intercept 3, y-intercept is 0. So we have to find out the line perpendicular to the given line and also passing through the point 3, 0. Therefore the required line is the required perpendicular line. Required perpendicular line is coefficient of x and y are interchangeable. 7x. Y coefficient 7 becomes coefficient of x. Y sign will be changing. Plus become minus. Plus some lambda equal to 0. So this is a line perpendicular to the given line. Since this line passes through 3, 0, subtracting 7 into 3 plus 0 plus lambda equal to 0. From this we can determine lambda. Lambda equal to 7 3 is 21. If you bring that to the right hand side, it becomes minus 21. So substitute the value of lambda in the equation, you will get the line. Therefore, required perpendicular line is 7x plus y minus 21 equal to 0. Or 7x plus y equal to 21. That's all about the problem. Finding the equation of the line perpendicular to the given line, passing point 3, 0. That's all about this problem, and I will stop this video here. And I will continue the other problems in our next video. Thank you.